Good afternoon, everyone, and happy new year to all of you. Coming to the CA Prostate, I would say CA Prostate is a concept, and to know each and every concept, you should know the basics. And for any cancer, basics is natural history. So whatever patient comes in, but early, even early stage, whether I do surgery, whether Maulik gives radiation, whatever, we cure 70% of the patient of CA Prostate, 30% will have a recurrence. That only PSA will increase, not any imaging will show anything. Out of that, we give some therapy and some patient will have a cure. But apart from that, 40% will develop metastasis and they will die. So it is the basic natural history of biology, you can say cancer, that even though with a curative intention, 10 to 15% patient will have a mortality. Coming to the cancer in India, by 2030, incidence is going to double with the malignancy, and majorities are in developed or metro cities, Bangalore, Delhi, Mumbai, Chennai, Ahmedabad is also one of the them. And what we see, localized disease is very early, 30% only. Majority of the disease we see in India is around 60 to 65% are in advanced stage. So when patient present in a metastatic disease, they progress to castrate resistance. So we all know that basics, that in a metastatic CA prostate, orchidectomy was the treatment. That is, we call it as a castration. But after 2 to 3 years, this patient's PSA is going to rise again, and that considered castrate refractory prostate cancer in spite of therapy. And even patient present in a localized stage, or they develop, they also have a higher chance of having, will live to CRPC at some point of time. So this is basics and natural history of the disease. So coming to the risk factor, yes, family history is very important. Those who have a first degree relative, they have a higher chance of 2.5 times higher chance of developing cancer. So majority disease we see in advanced stage. So what to do to prevent the advanced stage? So early detection is the key, and you are responsible for your health. But we cannot do screening of each and every male of the society. That is, population based screening itself is a hazardous. So only opportunistic screening. So those patient who is coming to your OPD with lower tract symptom should get PSA. So what are lower tract symptoms? That are defined in two ways. Either difficulty in storage of bladder, that is frequency, urgency, nocturia. And voiding, difficulty in voiding because of enlarged prostate, that patient present poor flow, straining, sense of incomplete evacuation. So it is easy to remember, FUN and IPSS. So patient symptom, PSA and digital rectal exemption. These three are initial important criteria. So what is normal value of PSA? Can anyone say what is normal value?
Less than 5, less than 4.
So suppose, I am not physician, but suppose for anemia, you say 10 or hemoglobin. So below 10, it is anemia. So it, is it so that below 4 patient will not have a malignancy? So it is not like that. We consider it as a reference value, never normal value for PSA. I will come later on. Apart from PSA, other parameters are free to total PSA and PSA density that we measure, and it is important. So for PSA, when Ashok sir was there, probably, where is he? There was a standard teaching that after PR, you don't do PSA for 3 days because it increased. It is not at all. Only increase in that level. Suppose you do in a Siemens laboratory and you do in Zydus laboratory, that laboratory instrumental aeration wearer curve. So you can immediately send after doing PR, you can send PSA. There is no harm. Effect of 5-alpha reductase inhibitor. Majority general practitioner write down Veltam F, Veltam D, Urimax. That D component or F component, it reduces the PSA by 50% if patient has taken for 6 months. So suppose patient is having PSA 4 and he is on that Urimax D, his actual PSA is 8, you have to double it. And majority early stage malignancy will mask by this. Any instrumentation, any prostatitis, definitely going to increase PSA level. So these are the 2019 data. Patient with the PSA 3 to 4, 25% chance of having malignancy. Even at the PSA 1, 10% having malignancy. So it is no normal PSA for us, any PSA, but probability of having malignancy will be less if your PSA is low. Apart from PSA, yes, it is written in literature. We are not using it, it is computerized software based score. Cutoff value is 7.5, 4K score, that different derivatives of PSA are used. So what are the current diagnostic method? It is pre-biopsy MRI. Previously, before 2012, when there was a PSI, we used to get immediate biopsy. But now it is, you get an MRI, MRI will give exact idea of the prostate, and accordingly we target that area. So we'll have a more diagnostic yield for that. And So now we are doing MRI plus cognitive fusion targeted biopsy. That will give us almost 95 to 98% results, and you will not miss the early malignancy. These are the example. MRI will give me exact in which part of the, whether it is in a base, whether it is in a mid gland, and I have to target. Apart from this targeted biopsy, I will take 12 core systemic biopsy also, because prostatic disease is multifocal disease. There are microscopic, and MRI will detect only clinically significant disease. So, and even it avoid unnecessary biopsy also. MRI will give this patient PSA was 30. Classical peripheral zone you can see, and this is BPH nodule. So I will avoid biopsy, and I will directly straightforward go for TURP in such situations. So MRI has dual advantage. It avoid unnecessary biopsy, because biopsy is also hazardous sometimes. Another example, PSA is only 4 and anterior fibromuscular stroma anterior. So my biopsy will not go in that area, then it will, I will, patient will have an advanced disease later on. So it is very important if a radiologist give me a good picture of MRI. So what is the current standard? If PSA more than 3 and abnormal MRI, 4K we are not using, but MRI, PSA density. If MRI positive, do biopsy. If MRI negative, but PSA density is more than 0.1, consider this patient to in a biopsy, and clinically significant prostate cancer, almost 98% you are sure. So only 2% chance of missing malignancy if you follow this protocol. Coming to the now pathology, core of biopsy, always 12 core biopsy. Suppose some tumor are then buccal mucosa or CA penis, we take a simple core. It is not at all. Surgeons or whatever, minimum 12 core biopsy has to be taken, and each core has to be sent separately. So pathologists will adequately examine. We have to give sufficient tissue to the pathologist to examine that. And now pathologists came in picture in 2015. They have glandular architecture, and 1 is the lowest score, 5 is the higher. So accordingly they decide the pattern, and between 6 to 10 is the Gleason score. But now they came up with the group. This is group is more clinically significant, because Gleason 7, either 3 plus 4 or 4 plus 3. Biology differs, because patient with the 4 plus 3 behave badly rather than the patient with the 3 plus 4. So Gleason 3 plus 3 considered clinically insignificant cancer. Reason is that 5 year survival is 100%. So if patient with this Gleason 3 plus 3, even though you don't do by and large, it is considered clinically insignificant, and MRI will not pick up this. So MRI will pick up clinically significant when you have a diagnostic dilemma that whether to do PSA or not to do, whether to do biopsy or not to do. But this is for early stage evaluation. Majority of patient I get from orthopedic or neurophysician with a backache, and their PSA is more than 100. There is no role of this all modalities. By and large, in DRE, we have a firm hard mass. We can take finger guided biopsy in such situations. So DRE, that is for early evaluation, all this investigation. Once you diagnose the prostate for primary, either bone scan or PSMA PET scan. PSMA PET scan increase the staging accuracy of the diagnosis. So once patient diagnosed with the CA prostate, initial dilemma was there whether to do biopsy or not to do biopsy. Once you diagnose, these all options are available, whether to do surgery, whether to do radiation, whether to give chemotherapy. Sir, I am confused where to go. So it is not mandatory, single option, sir. And important is observation, that is not known by and large. And there is difference between observation and active surveillance. Observation, our aim is only palliation. Older age, 80 years individual, I think I have a case that, yeah. No, will come. Our aim is only palliation, and in active surveillance we actively find out, because patient doesn't have any problem, so whether it progresses, and our aim is to treat that patient in a curative intention. So it is important to choose right options, and that management, all options depend upon the patient's age, their comorbidity, their performance status and cancer stage. For all medical officer, for any cancer, by and large, stage 1 and 2 localized. Stage 3, little bit advanced. Stage 4, spread outside the body. That is easy way to remember. So for observation, this was 77 year male in 2015. His prostate was 67, median lobe was there. PSA was 4.6 and high postoid residue. So, but TURP histopathology was 3 plus 3. So I kept under observation, and even he is still alive without any treatment. So each and every treatment has side effect. Orchidectomy has also side effect. Surgery, radiation, all side effect. So just observation, and when he will be symptomatic, I will offer him orchidectomy or hormonal treatment. So again, almost 7 years has been gone. Now orchidectomy, if patient will require more 3 to 4 years, he'll have it. So at the age of 77, I can offer this observation. This is one of the option. Surgery, yes, It includes the removal of the prostate, seminal vesicle, part of the vas, and also pelvic lymph node dissection. That can be done either by laparoscopic manner or by open, also by robotic method also. What are the advantage of doing surgery? We'll have an exact histopathology. Reason, what prostatic biopsy you did, there is 30% upstaging in the prostatic biopsy as well as the radical prostatectomy specimen. Microscopic periprostatic fat infiltration, you will not have an idea, suppose in MRI. But if you had submitted entire prostate, you will have an exact histopathology. So further treatment, you can individualize radiation and hormonal treatment. You can categorize each and every individual accordingly. And morbidity of sitting prostate means when patient advances, they have hematuria, clot retention, all local symptom, you can control by removing the prostate. So approach, either approach is equal. So my preference would be surgically fit patient, localized or RP versus RT. Locally advanced, offer RP along with radiation and hormonal therapy as a part of multimodality. Unfit patient, 100% radiotherapy. It can be given as a in locally advanced also. So advantage of RT is no surgery, no surgery related side effect. Biochemical recurrence, this is another important terminology. As we said in biology that 30% will have a recurrence in a 10 year. So after surgery, we have a specific definition for PSA. If our PSA is more than 0.2, this patient will consider biochemical recurrence. So those who are subjected to treatment, their PSA value 3 or 4 is considered quite high. So PSA is only 0.2 itself. After radiation, nadir plus 2, that is the definition for biochemical recurrence. These are the predictor of biochemical recurrence. If you have a histopathy, you can identify and you can treat accordingly. Radiation therapy, either at the adjuvant setting as a salvage, I will consider. Radiation therapy should be given once the continence stabilizes within 1 year of surgery. Majority of the cancer radiation should be given within 6 months. But CA prostate is that you can give up to 1 year, that is considered adjuvant therapy. And if you delay, that is good, that patient will have a little toxicity. And with IMRT and IGRT, complications rate are very rare and radiation therapy are also safe. So salvage radiation therapy is improved the prostate cancer specific survival when you give when PSA is between 0.2 to 0.5. So earlier PSA, if you give, patient will say, I don't have any trouble, but it is biochemical recurrence. If you treat, you will have a more survival. What imaging should be done in this stage? It is the PSMA PET scan is the only investigation of choice, and that has also limited sensitivity in detecting the disease when the PSA is low, but this is the golden time when you should give adjuvant RT. So most favorable treatment previously was TURP with orchidectomy. Orchidectomy is the only stage 4 disease. It is reserved for only metastatic disease. It is not for early CA prostate. And TURP when patient retention or when you are planning for radiation and orchidectomy. So no operation in older age, it's a myth. Incontinence is by and large myth. With recent technology in advance, it is not that much severe. And orchidectomy has these all side effects. Like female have a menopause, if you remove the testes, patient will have an andropause. So for metastatic disease, hormonal therapy, we have all three options: surgical castration, removal of both testes, and GnRH agonist and antagonist. I will not go in detail of that. But this is important that little is recognized that cardiovascular disease is second most common cause of death in CA prostate. So after orchidectomy, suppose within 1 year patient died, we will say okay, cancer was okay, but they died because of heart disease. That heart disease you had invited by giving agonist, because orchidectomy has, and as well as GnRH probably have a more metabolic effect on the body. So within 5 to 12 months, statistically significant if you give GnRH agonist. So how will you assess the metastatic disease? So PSA at 7 months, if PSA is low, their survival is still more than 5 or 6 years. If PSA is high, their survival is poorer. This is in metastatic stage. Now in 2015, our medical oncologist came into picture that apart from orchidectomy, if we add on some therapy, so they will have a more survival. So they came up with docetaxel, abiraterone, enzalutamide. These are oral molecule. Abiraterone, enzalutamide are oral. Docetaxel and cabazitaxel are injectable. So they have all sequence, how to give, where to give. I will not go in detail of that. But this therapy now considered standard of care for metastatic CA prostate. Not only orchidectomy is sufficient. You have to add on some therapy. And now we surgeon and radiation oncologist will also come into picture. In 2021, that surgery has also role as a cytoreductive radical prostatectomy as a locally treatment of metastatic CA prostate, and they have shown almost 2 years survival data, 90 to 100%. survival versus 66%. Probably might not be visible if no local treatment. So local, some form of local treatment is required. When we are considering overview, genetics has also importance. Advanced disease and those who have family history should be considered for genetic counseling. So one size doesn't fit for all. Prostate cancer treatment decision based on multiple factor. I can take any queries. Thank you very much.